Good morning, students. So today we are going to discuss the exercise 4.2 problem, and we already learnt about the six properties are there. On the basis of all those six properties, so as per the convenience, as per the requirements, we shall be following all those properties, right? In to get the answers. So let's see question number 5 till 4. I have already discussed. So the determinant, this is given. N equals to 2 times of determinant of A, B, X, B, C and Q, R, Y, Z, right? So first of all, we have to look at the result, that here the terms are independent and single term is there. And here, look at the left hand side. So we are given the row and columns, the sum of two terms. So in this question, what we need? We need this 2 times, first of all 2 multiplied by these terms are coming separately, individually and single term, right? So see, so we are using the operation property number 6, right? So using property 6, or you can say applying the operation. See, now we find that R1, R2, R3, ABC, R1, R2, R3 involved in ABC, and C1, C2, C3, there is B plus C, Q plus R and Y plus Z. That is, all terms are distinct. So what we prefer? We will prefer this R1 tends to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now the question arises here, why we are adding rows? Okay, because if we add columns C1, C2, C3, then you see each and every term is different. So we want to put the same term, similar term in each row and columns. So let's apply R1, R2 and R3. So we find BC, CA, AB. After adding all these elements, so we'll get, we can take 2 common, A plus B plus C. Similarly, this side Q is coming 2 times, P 2 times, R 2 times. So we are taking 2 common, and we can write P plus Q plus R. Similarly, if you add, then we will get 2 times of X plus Y plus Z. See the benefits? Here 2 is coming, right, in each and every term, and ABC, PQR cyclic expression has been formed, right? So now the remaining terms are as it is, C plus A, A plus B and R plus P, right? So just copy these terms. Now in the next step, as a result is what? 2 times of the determinant. So as the property states, we can take any term throughout the common from the rows or columns. So here, which term is common? See, 2, 2 and 2 is coming throughout in the row R1 as common. So we can take this 2 outside, right? So taking 2 common and write the determinant A plus B plus C, same as P plus Q plus R and X plus Y plus Z, and these terms remaining rows as it is. Okay, so you can write the elements here, same elements, no change at all. Alright, so now the next step, after getting A plus B plus C, and here is C plus A. Okay, so what we want? Only B, that is BQY, single term. So here we have the 2 terms, and here we have ABC, that is 3 terms. So if I subtract what? This row, that is R2. Okay, same as here, we will have R plus P, and here the next term is C plus A, R plus P. So we can see the third term is what here? Z plus X. Okay, with that, Z plus X, this term will come here. So what we get? So subtract this row and this row, that is R2 tends to R2 minus R1. So you can note the operation. We are writing R2 tends to R2 minus R1, right? So if we write R2 tends to R2 minus R1, then what we get? So just we are applying the operation. So we will get A plus B plus C. So we are applying this operation. R2 tends to R2 minus R1. So this minus this. And remaining thing as it is. So there is no change in R1. So we will write A plus B plus C. Then T plus Q plus R. Similarly, we will write here X plus Y plus Z as it is. Okay, student. So now R2 minus R1. So this minus this. So C and A. C and A will be cancelled. So what will have only? B. Right? Same as here. R plus P minus P plus Q plus R. R O P cancel. R O P cancel. So what will have? Q only. Similarly here, X or Z come in. So X or Z subtracted. So what will get? Minus Y. It clear? And the third row is as it is. What is the third row? A plus B and write third row as it is from the books. You can write third row A plus B, P plus Q and P plus Q and X plus Y. Okay, A plus B, P plus Q and X plus Y. So we can write here the same row here. A plus B and P plus Q or X plus Y. Right? So here in these questions we will get always what the similar term, cyclic term. Okay? I mean same pattern. So now let us remove these things. R2 minus R1 we have already applied. So let us remove this. Now let's see the next operation. Similarly, now look at R3. Right? This is the next step. R3. So in R3, here the term is what? X plus Y plus Z. Okay, we are writing this one also. So R3, we are writing R3 tends to R3 minus R1. So what we will get if we apply this operation? A plus B plus C, P plus Q plus R, X plus Y plus Z and minus B minus Q minus Y as it is, or R3 minus R1. So A plus B plus C minus this entire row. So we will get minus C, P plus Q cancel, minus R, then X plus Y cancel, minus Z. Right? And here is 2 was also there. Okay? Now, here we have got single term as the results. You can see P, BQ, BQ, Y. We almost got the result CRZ. CRZ. Now look at the very first step. What is there in the first step? ABC. So what we want? Only A. Clear? That is, we also need to have here only individual term. So what we can apply, which two rows or columns can be added so that we get here only single term. So see here minus B minus C and here is A plus B plus C. What we want? A. So if I apply R1 tends to R1 plus R2 plus R3. If I add all these three rows, then what I'll have? So right, what I'll have? A, B, C. So minus B, minus C cancel out. This will be cancelled. So we'll have only A. Okay. Now here Q, R, after adding all these elements. So Q or R cancel out. We'll get P. And here is X, Y, Z, Y, Z cancel. We'll get X. And the remaining terms as it is minus B, minus Q, minus Y, minus C, minus R, minus Z. So we have got single term. Right? After that, what we see? For two times is also coming. We need the same elements, but minus is not there. So we have also learnt in property 4 that the any number can be taken as common from throughout the row or column. So minus B can be written as minus 1 into B. Minus 1 into Q, minus 1 into Y. So we can take minus minus common from this row, that is second row, and we are taking minus common from third row. So outside what we get? We get minus 1 whole square. That is 2 times we are taking common into 2, and then the determinant APX B Q Y and C R Z. Right? So now this minus 1 whole square becomes plus, and this is 2 times of the same determinant, you can tell it. So which is the result? Hence proved. Clear? So in this question, the question is most important, as in board 4 marks. You can refer the 10 years, so then you will come to know this question asked many a times. Okay, because this exercise particularly containing one question of 4 marks. Alright, so you need to solve each and every question and the examples of the same exercise. So I hope you have the ideas that how we need to apply the operations, okay, how we can subtract 2 rows or columns in order to get the final result. So basically this exercise is depending upon the logics, right? So once you need to solve 2, 3, 4 questions or examples, then you will be coming into the practice and pattern that how and which operation can be applied, right? So this has been solved. Now I'm taking one more questions so that you can be more familiar with the exercise. Question number 6. Again the properties we have to use. So let determinant is given as 0 minus A B and A 0 C minus B minus C 0 equals to 0, we have to get. Okay. So delta equals to, see this is clearly what the example of 0 0 0. If you remember, if 0 coming in a principal diagonal or diagonal, okay, and so the determinant actually we studied in matrices. So this is the example of skew symmetric matrix, right? So taking minus common from all the rows, so how many rows are there? 3 rows are there. So minus 1 to the power 3. So what will get? 0 minus A B, then A 0 C minus B minus C or 0. Okay, so this becomes minus 0 A minus B minus A 0 minus C and B C or 0. Right, so what we have done? We have taken minus common throughout the rows. After this, now see 0 A minus B, that is this row and this column, what changes is there? Only symbol difference is there. So using property first, what was the property first? Remember? Not remember. So you have to learn the properties. Try to get, this was property first. Symbolically I have written, that is A dash means transpose of the matrix. But here in property first we studied that if we change the rows into columns of the entire determinants, then it would remain same, right? That all the rows or columns are interchanged each other, then the value of the determinants remains same. It means determinant of A goes to determinant of A dash. A dash indicating that we are interchanging rows into columns. So let us use this operation and then you will see what we will get, okay? So what we are going to do, this row is written as, that is converted into column. Similarly second row converted as second column, that is we are using what transpose of this. Then third row minus B minus C or 0, we will get what? This again transposition, okay? So now see, this is what we have to prove. 0 equation first, Now just find, is there any similarity, this determinant and this determinant? Can you find some similarity? Yes, see, 0 minus a b, a 0 this and this. So actually we have got what, the exactly the same determinant. It means this whole determinant can be replaced by delta using first. That is this result. I mean this whole determinant can be replaced by delta. Delta means determinant, okay, so minus delta. And here is what, delta is coming. So delta equals to, we have got delta equals to minus delta, and this implies delta plus delta equals to 0. Delta means determinant, okay. So 2 times of delta equals to 0, then determinant equals to 0 by 2, that is 0. And hence proved. I already told you that until unless you solve the 4-5 questions, examples, till then you cannot come into the practice that how we can get the result. So here I have used property first. Because if you add all these row and columns, you are not getting appropriate result. Hint it. So this was the very good questions. Okay. Now look at the next question number 7. So I am discussing the conjugative questions. So that in each and every questions you are learning something, that how we can get the result, which operation is applied. So see the next one, problem number 7. Make sure that you have learnt all the properties, okay. All the properties must be on your fingertips. And before proceeding to the exercise problem, you must have a look of the examples and try to get that how we can apply the operations. So see the result, 4a square, b square and c square, this is the determinant. So now this time, so first of all look at the result, 4 times a square, b square, c square. So the determinant containing a, b, c and a square, b square, c square. So see, a square, a, b, a, c, right? Row first and row, sorry, column first, a square, a or a. It means here the element is coming in rows as well as in columns. So it means in order to simplify this determinant, we are not going to add, we are going to take common and make sure if any determinant, anything is coming common, right? So you must prefer this property, right? This is also a property, okay, that we can take any number or constant or terms taken out as common. So we are taking common, and you must write what you are applying the equation. Taking a common from R1, and similarly we can take b common, b from R2 and C from R3, right? So after taking common, we'll get A, B, C. Determinant. So we have taken A common from this. So we'll get minus A, then B and C. Similarly, we are taking B common. So we'll get A and then minus B and C. And now in the last, we are taking C common, A, B or minus C. This actually we got A, B, C. Now again look at the result, A square, B square, C square, and here is A, B, C. Okay, so now can we have again common, right? Okay, so can we take again common from row? In this row we can't take common, and but in this column, that is column 1, there is what? A and A coming, right? As I said, we can take common easily to make the determinants for easier calculations. So we are taking A common from this, B from second column and C from third. And you must write this thing here, you know, taking common as I have written, okay? Write each and everything that comes in step marking, okay? So we will get A square, B square, C square. And now we have taken A common, so we will get minus 1, 1 and 1. Similarly, 1, minus 1, 1, 1, 1 or minus 1, right? So you can see we have almost very close to the result a square b square c square has been obtained. And now see one of the very important point I am going to tell you, if the determinant containing some terms or element especially one is coming, so then try to get zero, because after creating zero determinants becomes more convenient for the calculations as we need to solve the determinant later on. Okay, so see how we can get zero. So try to create as many as zeros in the determinant as far as it is possible. Okay, so see minus 1 1 1 minus 1 1 or 1, so which operation we can apply so that here all the six operations are free that you can apply all properties, but we are preferring which one, the last one. That means we are writing r1 tends to r1 plus r2. See, apply r1, that is this is the r1 and r1 is what, this plus this, so we get 0 again 0 1 and 1 2, right, and the remaining term as it is 1 1 minus 1 1 1 or minus 1. So clearly we have got two zeros, right, after being applied this operation. Now after getting two zeros, it is just what, very sufficient to expand the determinant. So this implies a square b square c square, and now let us expand the determinant along this row. So 0, I think you remember, if not then again try to get 0, we write this element and the suffixes, that is minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1, that is 1 only, as you have finished 4.1, so you must be familiar with this. So 0, and we delete this row and this column, so we will get what, this and this, since outside there is 0, so there is no need to expand determinant. Okay, you can write the element or you can write only 0 at this place, right, plus next actually will come minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2, because this is the element of a 1 2, so minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2, or then because there is outside 0, so into 0 and determinant, if you wish you can write determinant, otherwise you can directly write 0, this is for your explanation part. Okay, I am writing 0 and determinant. Now plus next is what, 2, so 2 and minus 1 to the power, the position of this element, first row and third column, that is 1 plus 3, and we write the determinant by deleting the rows and columns. So this 2 is coming in first row and this column, so we have the left elements 1 minus 1 1 or 1, so write 1 minus 1 1 or 1, right, so a square b square c square, as I said no need to write this determinant and the elements, you can write directly 0 plus this 0, that is, so finally we are going to have this term, this is also plus 2, so 2 into a square b square c square is also there, 2 into, now simplify this, 1 minus 1 into this minus 1, so 1 plus 1 becomes 2 and this is also 2, 2 into 2 4, or a square b square c square, so 4 into a square into b square into c square, right. So this is, you can see the result. Okay, I hope you have must have learnt about some operations of properties, that how we can get the result, how and which properties is very convenient, right. So we have seen that there are limited properties which can be commonly and frequently applied, like property 5, property 6, and it, that is taking common or adding all the rows or subtracting columns, right. So you are almost, I mean 90% question can be solved out and restricted only in these properties, right. So I hope you must have learned something and try to solve the further questions and ask your doubts to me. Thank you very much.